Hey, you know what we're all about? Discipling one another to reach and raise the next generation.
The next generation.
To live out God's truth. God's truth. Hey, listen, when you go to football practice, you know what you do. You get back to the basics. Luke, what are the basics?
You block and you tackle.
You get back to blocking and tackling. Yeah. Look, my son is playing football right now. He's loving football.
But he's learning to block and tackle.
Right? Yes, but right now what they have been doing, because they're in the playoffs and they're trying to get back to the basics, they are blocking and tackling. So for the next few weeks, Luke and I want to talk to you about the basics of leading an effective group. Whether you lead an on-campus group, an off-campus group, doesn't matter. We're going to get back to the basics, and we're going to teach you how to block and tackle in a group. Yep. But literally, do not tackle anybody. Don't block anybody in your group, because that might be
a problem. We want them to come back.
We want them to come back. We're going to teach you the basics. So this week, we are talking about how to start and end your group on time, and we're talking about the importance of prayer. So Luke, talk to us.
Well, of course, in any group, and home groups even more especially, so time is important, time is valuable. You never want to overstay or just monopolize someone's time. You want to be very good stewards of the time of the people in your group, and you want to respect that. And so, of course, by any means, you want to start and end on time. So the importance of that is definitely there. And with a home group, like I mentioned, it's more important because you're in someone's home.
Yeah. Yeah, I know every week in my home group, and I know you feel this way as well, is we eat first. So we start at 5:30, we eat. And then we usually try to have our discussion time by about 6:15. But I've noticed my people, they love to fellowship.
Talk a whole lot longer.
Oh, they do. They're always talking. They're just fellowshipping, and it's great. And I want them to fellowship, but we have to have our discussion time as well. So here's a technique that I've actually been using, and I hope they're not watching this video, but here's the technique that I've been using. I'll actually go into the living room, and we need a few extra chairs to move. So I'll take some of the chairs from
the
kitchen.
And you'll start moving them over?
Yeah, and I'll start moving them in. And they're like, oh, okay, yeah. We need to go ahead and wrap up. So they'll get their dessert. They'll come.
It's an unsent signal.
Yeah, exactly. And so that's how we start on time. But then I've noticed that sometimes our discussion goes too long. So how do I, like, land the plane? What am I supposed to do when, man, they're talking? It's a great topic. You know, this last Sunday we were talking about worry. And that really resonated with everybody in the group. So how do I help them land the plane and not make it weird? Like, well, it's time to go. How do I do that?
So Andrew, in our group, we always circle back around to the big idea. And so when I'm facilitating discussion at whatever point, if we've gone a long time or if it's just coming to a natural close, we'll always recap the big idea of the sermon or the discussion or whatever we're covering in that group. Mm-hmm. And then at that point, so we'll cover it and then we'll transition into prayer.
Yeah, that's great. You know, you said, like, circle back around to the big idea and help your people to apply it to their life. Like, here's something that you need to do this week and then walk away.
Because of this takeaway, yes.
Oh, I love that. That's a great idea. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, sometimes when we're talking a long time, sometimes I want to try to, like, rush the prayer time. It's like, okay, I know our discussion went long, but we need to, like, get out of here.
Yeah.
So how do I not rush through prayer? What am I supposed to do?
Well, I think it's important to take the time to intentionally ask your group for prayer requests.
Yeah.
You want to make sure that everyone in your group is cared for, and even as a group leader or a host, you're shepherding the people in your group well.
Yeah.
And part of that is taking the time to just be intentional and ask and care and pray for those in your group. And that goes with asking for prayer requests.
Yeah. Well, what about when, if you have, and listen, I know we all have a lot of needs and a lot of, like, prayer things that we want our group specifically to pray for. But what about some of those that are in your group that, man, they take a long time to tell you a prayer request? And there's nothing wrong with that, but, you know, they take 5 or 10 minutes to tell you about, you know, someone who is struggling with something. And so how do you try to help them along, because there again, that's kind of eating into some of your prayer time. I mean, we want to hear about it. We need to hear about it, and we deeply care, but we want to make sure and help them. You know, one of the ways that I do is sometimes I will, like, while we are talking, I will pass around the prayer journal.
And I'll say, hey,
yeah, and everybody writes their name, and they write their prayer request. And so we pass it around versus, like, sharing it verbally. Sometimes that can be a little better. And then once I get the book back, I will read it, and I'll kind of read everybody's prayer requests, and I'll acknowledge all the people in the room. And then me personally, like, I will pray openly about every single one of those prayers. And then when, you know, the next day,
you can reach out.
And I'll send it out to the group. I send it out on group text or send it out in the group email or whatever. And same way with our BF class, we post it on our Facebook page. And so we really try to, like, let everybody know, but we try to help that time along, because there again, you know, we want to start and we want to end on time, and we don't want to be too rushed for prayer either.
Yeah, one thing we did in our Bible fellowship class on Sunday was, it was funny, we said, tell the thing, not the story, which is very similar to what you're covering with writing it in the book.
That's great.
And so as group leaders, that's where you can go and really build that relationship with your group, is you can say, okay, you know, Sally had something with her knee. We're praying for better health with the knee. Well, then you can go as a leader or as a host and show intentionality and really ask and care for your people in that way.
I like that.
So it really builds that relationship from a leader to those in the class, to where that relationship is growing and you can genuinely ask about what they have going on.
Tell the thing, not the story. I like that. That kind of sets the precedence. Mm-hmm. Hey, look, we love this time with you. We're drinking our coffee. I'm going to get Luke to be drinking some coffee in a few weeks. He drinks water, but that's about it. Yeah. We got to get him drinking
coffee. I'm healthier.
But hey, listen, we love this time with you, and we can't wait to see you Sunday.
See you guys Sunday.